When you are learning something new, you spend a lot of time investing in that skill, whether it be coding, marketing, a soft skill, whatever the case may be. And as you're investing more and more time into this skill to either get a new job, grow in your career, there's always this worry in our heads of, am I doing the right thing? Am I going to regret it? What if I don't even like this in a few years or a few months from now? And this is a constant worry that I know so many of us have had around, am I choosing the right career? How do I find a career that I really love? I'm going to share with you today how I was able to discover and find a career that I really love. As someone who's been there firsthand coming from the fashion industry and doing a complete 180 into tech and even in technology, growing in different roles, I'm going to share with you some tips and insight that I've really learned and how to hone in and find my dream career. Before we get started though, make sure to hit that subscribe button for more tech and coding related content. Leave in the comments any questions you have, or I'm curious to hear even, have you found your dream career? Are you still working towards it? All right, let's get into it. I see some of these kind of topics covered, and one thing that a lot of people say is, you know, or not a lot, but some people say is, detach yourself from your career. It doesn't matter. You don't need to love your career. It's just a source of income. But we spend more time in our career, in our 9-to-5, than we do with our families, with our friends. It's probably throughout a large part of our life, where we spend the majority of our time. And it's essential, in my opinion, to actually enjoy what you do. If you don't, you're going to be miserable. You're going to detest going into work every day. And if you think that you can completely turn that off after 5 p.m., you can't. The energy that you have through the day and how you feel about your work will continue to flow outside of work. That's why it's so important to find a career that you actually really enjoy. Maybe even love. That's up to you to decide. As we continue to get older, time becomes more precious. And with the time being more of a value, we don't want to spend time in places that we are uncertain will bring us a return or that we will really enjoy. Going back to the coding analogy here, if you are learning how to code and you're hitting some road bumps, you might be like, is this really for me? Is this something I really see myself sticking with long term? What if it's just something that's temporary or it's a fad? How do I know? There are a few ways I can really help you uncover if you're on the right track to landing your dream career and how to uncover what areas to really spend your time focusing in. For me, one of the biggest ways was actually utilizing other people. So whether this be friends, different connections, and hearing about their experiences. Now, everyone's experience is completely unique and you can't base your decisions on someone else's experience, but if there is a trend after speaking to a few people in a certain industry, for example, the tech industry, and you're like, this sounds really something that I would like. You know, there are cons, but the pros definitely are stronger and something I'm gravitating towards. It's a good way to get a sense of how other people feel about the industry that you're considering getting into, or more specifically, the job or career path. And for me, this did a really good job of understanding. You go online and you see all of these pros and these highlights of the different career paths, and it seems all great. But when you actually speak to someone who's gone through that process and gone through that career, you not only get the pros and the positives, but you also get the negatives, which I think is almost more important in the situation that you are looking to land or grow into your dream career, because then you know what you're really in for. Yes, you know the positives, but here are the negatives. And are you okay with those negatives, or is it too much for you? Another way that really helped me discover my dream career is to try different things. Where most of my curiosity lied was around coding, but I also too was trying other things. I was trying the marketing side of things. I was actually trying photography for a little bit. Different kind of skills to see, is this something I enjoy? And if it is something that I enjoy, maybe it will be better left as a hobby, or is it potentially a career? And for me, if you want to learn a new skill or play around or be curious about different things, I have kind of a fun little rule that I put on these, which is the 10-minute rule. Spend 10 minutes every day learning this. Now, what does this do? We all have 10 minutes that we can give to learning something new. So first of all, it takes off this pressure of feeling as though you have to spend hours and hours a day to learn something new and invest all this time, only to not be sure if you really want to go there or not. And the second thing this does is it makes you excited. For me, when I'm learning something new or exploring a different area, knowing if I'm only spending 10 minutes a day, it just It makes me actually look forward to it versus dread it because it's a long hour or I have to commit so much time and energy towards it. Another way that really helped me in understanding the career path I wanted and to understand my dream career was to look back and evaluate my past. So I actually looked back at the time I was working at a large company and I was kind of unhappy. I was doing software development work. I've been doing it for 5 years. I absolutely loved the software developer work itself, but there was something missing and I couldn't figure out what it was. So rather than just completely jumping ship, thank goodness I didn't, and being like, I'm just gonna abandon this and learn a different skill completely, I thought, you know what I'm gonna do is look back over the past few months, even years, at what I really enjoyed about this job and about other bosses and other career paths I have done, and then also to, most importantly, what I have not enjoyed. And through that, I quickly discovered that for me, one of the big things is I like the best of both worlds. I love technology, I love code, being in the weeds with it, but then I also love people. I love teaching, I love educating. Can I combine that in any way? Well, that's how I ended up in developer relations, and that's my dream career. And I am so excited about that, but it took a lot of time. I mean, you've seen me grow so much through this YouTube channel, through me sharing my honest and authentic journey in tech, that even what you land, your first job, your first career, maybe it's the right industry and you're very passionate about this industry like I am about technology, but then a few years in, you're just like, you know what, this career path, this role path is not for me. It doesn't mean completely jump ship and abandon the industry, but rather take a look back at your experience and think back as to what you enjoyed and didn't enjoy. And if it's more you're not enjoying, maybe it be company culture or bosses, that will give you good insight as to what the real issue here is. Is it that you're just completely burnt out and over a certain industry and career path, or is it you just need a change and something to kind of switch it up? Another big thing for me is visualization. I know you're probably thinking, Tiff, I don't want to visualize, like, what are you talking about? But just hear me out on this one. If you take a few minutes and really think about where you want to be in 5 years from now, in 10 years from now, what does that look like to you? Does it look like going into an office every day? Does it look like leading a team, collaborating with people, building really interesting technology? What does that look like to you? And of course, through our different experiences and as we grow as people, this will change to what we think we want today to what we want in the future. But it really gives us a good sense and a good roadmap as to what our wants and needs are and where we want to be growing. And that's a huge aspect too. For me, example, when I was thinking about what I wanted in the next 5 years, I knew I wanted to be remote. I knew I wanted a high-paying salary. There's nothing wrong with that. I knew I wanted flexibility. Those were the three things. And is there such a world where you can get all these three things? Well, yes, of course there is. And one of them being the career path that I chose. And I love that I was able to tick off all of those three boxes that were really important to me. Now, maybe some of these are less important to you and one or two of them are more important to you, or maybe they're all equal, but it's really key to understand as to where you see yourself in the future so you can align your learnings and your career goals based on that. For me, even if I'm not at my complete dream, say I wasn't, I am, but say I wasn't at my complete dream path or dream career, just knowing that you're actually taking the steps to get there itself is so rewarding and fulfilling, I think, that you can be like, you know what? I know I have to make this step or do this role for a little bit to get to my dream career. And I think that's really important too, is just realizing that your first job, your second job, your third job might not relate to your biggest dream career, but it takes time. And I think the journey is so rewarding on its own. Just being able to know that this is the direction you want to go into. And the last thing I really want to highlight here is we evolve. We evolve and we change. So what does that mean? Well, for finding your dream career, it's important to do all the things I mentioned to really help hone in on where your interest lies and trying new things and applying the 10-minute rule and meeting and networking with other people. Or even if you don't like networking, at the very least, just talking to other people to hear about their experiences. The biggest takeaway though is I have a computer sitting right here. We have, most of us do anyways, we have the internet at our fingertips. And with that comes a lot of power. We can literally learn whatever we want, whenever we want. I think the biggest thing for me is, the biggest secret I realized is, don't overthink it. If you are passionate and interested about something, and you have gone through the different steps and it just seems to really be a good fit, then just go for it. I think we truly live in a time where what we do today, what we do for the next decade, doesn't have to equate to what we do for the following decade. Meaning, I feel like in our parents' generation, or you know, depending on what age you are, but for my parents' generation anyways, it was like, you pick this career and this is what you are doing for the rest of your life. Maybe at the same company for the rest of your life. That's not the case anymore. You want to be a coder for 10 years and then you want to go be a project manager. You can do that. It is possible. You can continue to upskill and utilize those interchangeable skills as you grow in your career. And maybe some of you disagree with me. Maybe some of you are like, nope, we need to become a specialist and focus in. You can. 10 years is a long time. You can become a specialist in something and then get tired of that and want to change it up. And that is totally okay. Don't let your decisions, make smart decisions that you can see yourself in this career path for a long time, but don't make decisions thinking about yourself in, for example, 30 years from now, because we don't even know what the workforce will look like. It could be a completely different set of jobs. So I think the most important takeaway here is just continue to be curious, continue to learn, and be open to new things as they come your way. Because at the end of the day, your dream job, your dream career will continue to evolve as you do too. And that's why it's so important to stay open. All right, I hope you really enjoyed this video. It is a topic I'm so passionate about, having evolved in my career and getting to a stage where I absolutely love what I do, but also being aware that that could change. And I'm okay with that because I'm building real valuable skills now that can be transferable, and that's what you can do too. Thank you all for watching. I hope you found this video very valuable and insightful. If you do, give it that thumbs up, and I'll see you all soon. Thanks, everyone.